Okay, so I updated my phone again. Samsung Galaxy S2, Android 4.03 on the Resurrection mod, custom firmware, and it has the Cyanogen mod theme on it, which comes stock with this mod. Everything works. I've had great success with this. I've had very, very, very little application force close. And I just want to show you what my battery was like. At 42%, it took 13 hours and 29 minutes. So I still got 42% battery left. That's using 2x battery. It shows it. This is the stock background that comes with it. I will show you the firmware that it's on. It's got the face unlock and all that. I'm not going to go through that. There's the mod here, Remix ICS 9.2. The market works. I loaded all that. Make sure you get the XXLPB because I had the original one that was more of a Samsung stock mod. It was a modem and firmware XXLPB. And it worked really good, but this one works better than the Samsung original. For me, it did.
Where did you get that? On your feet.
This is just the music. Turn that down a bit. I'm going to show you the quadrant on it. I loaded the brand new quadrant, which was built February 13, I believe, or 14. Sometime in that week. And I'm gonna, February 13, this is the brand new version. I'm gonna go to system info. And every time you run this, make sure it says two cores, like mine only says one. So basically what we have to do is we have to optimize the phone a little to clear out some memory and some cache and all that fancy stuff. Because the phone's not reading two cores as of what it should be. Because I want to give you guys an accurate benchmark reading. You see probably no cache I have to clear. No, you have a good cache. I'm just going to go here and do a quick boost on this one. So I'm just using One Touch Optimizer. This is a Netquin, this security one, which has the optimizer. This is the Advanced Task Killer and Android Assistant. So now we're gonna go back to Quadrant Standard. Still reading one core, so there's something not right here. So I'm going to try to close the application and see what's the matter. I'm going to go back here to Tools and Android Assistant, which I didn't do before. I'm going to do a System Clean. And we're going to do a Cache Cleaner, because there's probably something here. Clear All, yep. What else is there? Battery Bash. No, that should be good. We're going to optimize one more time. I'm going to turn on the Wi-Fi so at the end of that benchmark reading, I can get the results quicker. The Wi-Fi is just behind me. Because I opened this so many times, I bet you it's going to force close on me. But I've had very little force close. So we're just gonna wait a sec here. I know what it's gonna do, a force close. There, no force close. It was just a freeze here. Still one core. This is really weird today. I'm going to try One Touch Optimizer one more time. It's using so much CPU right now, I don't know why. I don't even know why I have that open. There we go. That's a proper reading. Let's see how it reads now. I don't care what the current or max frequency, but it should be the max is 1200 and the minimum 200. But that's what it's currently reading. Two cores. And that's my firmware, XXLPB. So we're going to go back and run this benchmark. Run the full benchmark. Just keep a note that from the old benchmark to the new update, it does run slower at first. Don't know why that is. I've heard the new one supports multitasking and all that. Wait one sec. I just want to show you guys the FPS. And do I want to proceed? Yes. So my device gets a score of 4001. Nothing overclocked, just a little bit of optimization. And you can see Samsung Galaxy Nexus and Samsung Galaxy Tab just right under. They get under 3000, which is weird. Don't know why. Maybe if you root it and put a custom firmware and ROM and stuff on, might get better results, but thanks for watching. That's what I get, 4001 on Quadrant Benchmark. Thanks for watching.